Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading The Path, Tome 7, The Kraken, which I found right here in the Mayor's House in Rivervale. Tome 7, The Kraken. Verse 46. Days and weeks had passed when one day the vassals crossed a dismal sea with water dark as a raven's feathers. Giant gray monoliths stretched aloft like spears, and a misty shroud hung over the passage like a veil. Still the vassals remained steadfast, and they had almost passed the fog, when an enormous creature raised itself up from the sea. It had tentacles, thick as wooden logs, and its eyes shone red in the gloom of the night. Verse 47. The monster heaved forward a tentacle and battered it against the ship with all its might. Wood ruptured, and the mast broke apart. The vassals screamed with terror, shock, and panic, as they realized they had no hope in opposing the creature completely unarmed. This time it was Keteron who proved his fortitude. Verse 48. While the tentacles of the creature raged, and fountains of black water erupted from the sea, he walked towards the bow of the ship, close enough to look directly into the eyes of the monstrosity. Selna yelled words of warning, but he ignored her, as he knew what had to be done. For one moment, silence reigned as the creature scrutinized its seemingly small opponent with suspicion. It then raised itself from the depths, each tentacle wrapped around one of the monoliths, and opened its demonic maw, filled with fangs as long and sharp as fence posts. Bones, planks, and algae fell out, and a rotten stench hit Keteron. Yet he did not lose heart, nor did he even twitch, for he was filled with his faith in Malthus and the righteous path. Verse 49. And so the creature sprang towards Keteron, its abysmal jaws fully opened, ready to devour him. For the last time he turned to face his comrades, Malthus's first vassals, and gave them a sad but certain smile. Suddenly he was engulfed in lightning bolts. Verse 50. White and glaring, they were numerous, and as thunderous as the roar of a hurricane. They flickered around his body, flashing from his fingertips and even from his very eyes. And before Selna or any of their companions could even begin to realize what was happening, he dove into the beast's maw. Verse 51. How fast the expression of greed and joyful hunger faded from its demonic visage. It shouted out so loudly that it was audible from Kille to Arctwind, from Kyra to Nerim. Filled with pain, it thrashed about, lashing its tentacles to escape the agony. But it could not, for its fate was decided. And then, after numerous minutes of anguish, it burst like a ceramic jar thrown to the ground. Its flesh was brown, its blood black, and a thousand small pieces rained down on the befuddled vassals and their ship. Barely had the remains of the creature touched the cold darkness of the sea and the wooden surface of the ship when they dissipated. When it was all over, there was no evidence left of the monster's existence, except for the splintered mast and the disappearance of Keteron. Verse 52. Incredulous, unable to comprehend what had occurred, the vassals remained rooted where they stood. Yet it was Selna who had the scales fall from her eyes, and so she stepped in front of her friends and proclaimed with a loud voice. Verse 53. Do not mourn his death, brothers and sisters. He died a hero and saved all of our lives. Verse 54. One of the vassals, an old man, said, How was he able to summon the storm? Asateron and the Eterna were also able to work these wonders, and their hearts were corrupt. I do not understand, Sister Selna. Please explain. Verse 55. And Selna responded, Magic is neither vile nor good. It was bestowed upon us by the gods, and we must decide whether to use it for mischief or for good. Verse 56. Thereupon the old vassal asked, But what if somebody misuses this gift, like the Eterna did over all those centuries? Who will judge them righteously, as they are mightier than 5 dozen soldiers? Verse 57. Now it was Malthus's voice, which resonated from Selna's mouth, godly and illustrious. They punish themselves. Magic is a trial and a burden, and only the most path-abiding of the faithful will not succumb to it. Those who do will never find their way to the eternal paths, which await those of you who worship me during your lifetime. You shall persecute these wild mages, hunt and bring justice to them, for they endanger the peace of the kingdom which you will build under my aegis. Verse 58. And once again the vassals recognized truth in the Lightborn's words. Few there were who discovered magic within themselves over the course of the voyage, but those who did unveiled their gift and used it for the welfare of the society, and were not driven by greed and vested interest. For only as a consequence of their comrade's martyrdom, the holy Ketteron, was it possible to continue sailing, for he had slain the demonic beast. And so it happened that this moon came to be known as the Kraken. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal, The Path, Tome 7, The Kraken.